Yes, I'm like Kreskin.
Better.
Yeah, better, yeah. That's okay. Why he's dead and I'm alive.
There you go.
You know why he's dead, Chet?
Because there's only room for one of you.
Well, also, he didn't thrash.
Oh, that's true. He died. There you go.
Yeah, he died.
Yep.
Yeah,
he picked the wrong choice.
Exactly. Thrash or die.
There you have it. Kreskin, out of here. Oh, here's one from another senior citizen. Well, kind of like a senior citizen. Dear Dr. Fuck, I am a 60-year-old drunk, and I recently went on a trip with a friend. Uh-oh, this is all starting to sound like the same family like you were talking about.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, let me get it. I am a 60-year-old drunk, and I recently went on a trip with a friend. But I must admit, I was hoping there was going to be more, but instead of getting some ass, she convinced me of going into business with her. Is she using me, or do you think I still have a chance? Signed, Rich Lonely Drunk.
Well, Rich Lonely Drunk, let me tell you something. Once you have the money, you have the power. Once you have the power, you get the woman. So you're doing it all wrong. And number two, why are you taking a girl out on a trip when you have all that money? You can just easily go to Thailand and get little hookers.
There you go.
Thank you.
And you could get also, a ton.
Since you have a lot of money, buy Poser Holocaust, Thrash or Die at Amazon, iTunes, CD Baby, and Facebook merch store.
Okay, and there's some great advice for all those people as well, and I hope everybody was marking it down, and I hope this answered everybody's questions, because I know that they are tuned in this evening, and they are listening very intently to the wise words of Dr. Fuck.
You are all welcome out there. Now go buy Thrash or Die, Poser Holocaust at iTunes, CD Baby, Facebook store, and Rewind the Tape. I forgot where else.
There you go. And from what I hear, too, if you don't get all your answers tonight from Dr. Fuck, if you listen to Poser Holocaust, all the answers will come to you subliminally. Is that true?
Exactly. Actually, play it backwards. You know, you're not going to hear satanic messages. What you're going to hear is actually advice of how you can get a girl. It's that simple. Just play it back, except for Fist Fucking Metal. Play that one forward.
And that gets the girl, too.
That gets all the girls. And girls out there, you know, actually, if you do have a boyfriend and he seems to be losing a little interest, you know, grab the salad and throw it up in the air, if you know what I mean.
Oh, my God. Okay, now is a good time for another break. Let's take a quick break, and we'll get right back to the doctor.
Yes.
And we are back with Dr. Fuck, and a few more questions. Are you ready, doctor?
Yes, I am. I'm always ready.
Okay. Dear Dr. Fuck, my name is Jeannie, I'm 21, and I live in Connecticut. I am a virgin, but recently have been very tempted to do the deed with my boyfriend of 2 months. I still think I am too young and don't want to make a huge mistake. How long should I wait, and what age is acceptable to lose one's virginity? Help in Connecticut.
Wow, a virgin that's 21, that's a rarity these days. Well, I think you would make a huge mistake. There's just, you know, just go up to your boyfriend and ask him one question, and depending how he answers it, you should give it up to him or not. Just ask him, are you aware of Thrash or Die? And if he says no, then don't give it to him. You know, go find somebody else. But if he says yes, yeah, do everything, even anal.
Thrash or Die is the key to losing one's virginity, really.
Exactly. I mean, he's not worth it if he's not aware of my band.
Very good advice. So, doctor, when did you lose your virginity? And is it true you never forget your first?
No, I'll never forget mine because I was 13 and she was 36.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. Yeah, no, actually, that's actually a true story.
Oh, my God.
But, you know, it's different when guys get molested. Look, they turn out normal like me.
So how old is she now?
I don't know, like 90, I guess. I have no idea. And she's going to the Middle East this week.
Oh, my God. Okay. Very good. Here's our next question for you, doctor.
Okay.
Dear Dr. Fuck, where I live, sheep are more or less my coworkers. Oh, boy. And one day, I let my fantasies get the best of me and actually made the love to one of the sheep. Now I have, like, furballs in my penis. What do I do, and how do I keep this from my family? Sheepish in Indiana. Good luck.
Well, you know, the thing is that you really do not know how to make love to sheep. What are you doing, rubbing your penis on his fur? I mean, come on, there's no fur in the sexual organ. You're totally, you know, stop rubbing it anywhere and just insert, that's all. That's all you have to do. And actually, I don't know how I knew that answer.
So what is your advice to him on how does he keep this from his family? I mean, should he just, like, soak it in Epsom salts and hope that the fuzz comes out or something?
No. I think he should tell his family because everybody in this world deserves a good laugh.
And you don't want to keep him... You don't want to keep important stuff like that from your family either.
No. And there's a website called motherless.com that I advise you to film some of it and put it up. and send it to your family.
And then that way...
Motherless.com.
You know, that's very good advice. Because if you put something like that online, maybe there's other people that experience this problem that could help him.
Yeah, and not only that, I mean, if a guy is making love to a sheep, he is a complete loser. But if you put yourself up on Motherless, you'll become a celebrity overnight.
What if it's a very attractive sheep?
I think the fur balls is worth it. Well, then again, I wouldn't know how to know. I don't know what I'm talking about.
I think we're going to take a really quick break here, and we're going to
break. I just want to say one thing.
Oh, sure.
There's no sheep in Florida. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, so there's no chance of any of that happening in Florida.
Well, not with Dr. Fuck, that is.
Not with Dr. Fuck. No sheep on your property.
No. I'm not into animals.
That's well, not what you... Okay, so this is a really good place to take a break. So we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back with the doctor. Keep it locked. Okay. And we're back, and we have a couple more questions. We have plenty of questions. We're not even able to get them all in. It's only a two-hour show, but we're going to do what we can. Here's our next question. Dear Dr. Fuck, how do I get my girlfriend to let me do anal on her, and also how do I get her to stick her finger in my ass? Oh, my Lord. Signed, Body Shop Guy in North Carolina.
Oh, Body Shop Guy in North Carolina, number one. You should dump that girl because you're gay. Seriously, I mean, you want a finger in your ass? I advise you to go inside a men's bathroom and have a guy do it, or go check your prostate. As far as having anal sex with a girl, look, it's the same feeling, I guess, as having anal sex with a guy. It's an anus, so just do it to a guy. They like it. The gay guys like that. Girls, obviously yours doesn't because she hasn't requested it, so come on, man. Come out of the closet already. Thank you. Next question.
Oh, there you go. Okay, the next question. Dana in Wisconsin wants to know, how many Viagra should I take when going on a date with my best friend's mom? Oh, my.
Ooh. Well, actually, I don't think... this is a case where, you know, like the previous caller, I told him not to take his life. This guy should... He should die. Seriously, you should kill yourself because, number one... Anybody that needs Viagra should die. I mean, what's the point of living if, you know, you can't do that naturally? And number two, and more importantly, what are you doing wanting to bang your best friend's mom? You're a scumbag, and you should die. But before you die, enter your bank account and buy a bunch of copies of Thrasher Dies, Pogo Holocaust, and give it to all your friends. That way your friends will listen to the CD, love it so much, and show up at that funeral. Because if you don't do that, nobody's going to show up.
Great advice. So you think Viagras are very harmful to your health and they're like the devil's tool?
I wouldn't know.
In other words, Viagras are for losers and people that should just be dying.
Yeah, exactly. Especially ones that want to bang their best friend's wife. I mean, come on. Mom. I mean, and wife.
Maybe that's another question somewhere.
Exactly. So they should die. And, you know, no offense, but, you know, I'm saying this from the kindness of my heart. That way you're going to be kind to me and buy my CDs.
There you go. And everybody, before you do die, make sure you empty your bank account, buy all your CDs, and spread joy throughout the world so your death isn't a total tragedy.
Exactly. And to make your death much easier, just convince yourself that you don't know how to thrash.
Oh, there you go. Then you have no choice.
There you go.
Yeah. There you go.
If you thrash, it's impossible to die.
Absolutely.
I'm living proof of that.
Yeah, there you go. Here's another one. This one is from Mark in Montana. Mark in Montana writes, "Dear Dr. Fuck, my wife and I have been married for 15 years, but we have not had sex in close to a year. I still
wow.
find her attractive. How do I reignite that spark?"
Have your wife bring over one of her slutty friends and make out with your wife as her friend gives you oral. There's nothing like a little strange in the little relationship there, and you'll get turned on, and then either that or close your eyes and think of another girl.
Or buy a Thrash and Die, Thrash or Die CD.
Yeah, buy that. Nothing will get you more in the mood. Yeah, Jet, you know, you're the one that should be answering questions of love. Look at that. You're so knowledgeable.
I am, but we need a male point of view on this
type
of thing.
Yeah, that's right.
And you really are the doctor. I just kind of speculate and learn by doing.
Exactly.
So there you go, Mark in Montana. Go out to, I don't know, where do you find these chicks? Like, an airport bar? Where do you find these women to bring home to your wife?
No, she should know. Every girl out there has that loose friend. Right, Jet? Don't you have a couple loose friends?
No.
Don't you? No?
There is none in my church group. There's not one single one in my church group that would do something like that.
Okay. The church group is where there's a bunch of them.
That's where they're all at.
They're all there. That's where you find them.
Well, just bring your whole church group home to your wife.
They'll be screaming hallelujah. Yeah, they love to scream God a lot.
They'll be screaming, oh God, and hallelujah all night long.
Yeah, exactly. And Jesus.
And Jesus. There you go. And play Thrash or Die during the orgy.
Exactly.
Just to keep it going.
By a church.
Oh, dead. Perfect advice.
Messiah. You know, it's a pro-Jesus song.
Yeah.
Anybody out there reads the lyrics, you know, it's Jesus comes back and he kills people.
That's
like the Bible says.
That's right. He's killing all those sinners.
Exactly. That's it, the posers. Well,
so the posers. They're all the same.
Exactly.
So there you go. Thrash or Die can be a religious experience as well.
It is, actually. It's a total religious. It's because of Thrash or Die. I've heard a lot of women say, oh, God, oh, Jesus.
Yep. See, there you go.
There you go.
Some more great advice from the doctor. We're going to take a quick break and one last question when we get back. Stay tuned. And we're back with one last question. And the question is, Dear Dr. Fuck, as of late, I am obsessed with MILFs and cougars. Uh-oh. I am only in my 20s, but the women I am attracted to are mostly in their 40s, and some even older. How do I approach these women without seeming like a stupid little kid to them? MILF hunter.
Oh, this is very simple. There's two places you can go to pick up MILFs and cougars, and it's a no-brainer, actually. Number one, go to the airport and look at any airplane leaving to the Middle East. And those are easy. And also funerals. When a wife, like, loses a husband, you know, that's a great place because they're now single. And, and they're very sad. And you got to be very thoughtful and caring and explain, the loss and be very thoughtful for her. And in no time, you'll have her head behind her head like Bugs Bunny. Legs behind her head, I meant.
That is great advice. So airports and funerals are, like, some of the best places.
Exactly.
What about,
just go to the Middle East. You know, girls love getting, MILFs love getting sand in their vajayjay.
That's so very true. And we know how to cure that. And, you know, speaking of that, I know you have given some very great advice today to some very common problems, really. And now people can, this is all going to be podcasted. So if people want to go back to, maybe in 2 months, they're like, oh, I think I heard the doctor give some advice on this. They could go back and refer to all this on the podcast, right?
Yeah, they can go back and listen to it if they, somehow forget what I said. And before you know it, your pickle's getting wet.
There you go. absolutely fantastic. And we're going to be right back. We're going to wrap it all up. Oh, I'm so discombobulated wrapping things up. That's another really good thing to do, though, by the way, on Valentine's Day. If it's going to be like a one-night stand, wrap it up.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Always wrap it up. That's another advice I just wanted to say, that no glove, no love. Always use a condom, everybody out there.